but she is determined. And she was here years ago at a conference, and I saw the release of God on her life. I saw her release all of her emotions and her apprehensions, and I said, oh my goodness, something is happening to this young lady. So Joyce Mirandes, we call her Amy Joy, is an astute businesswoman. Her focus is mentoring women to maximize their God-given talents in business and ministry. She focuses in teaching and empowering women to be effective physically. She lost about 460 pounds. What was it? 65 pounds. I didn't know when I started. You're like, oh my goodness. I hope you have a before picture, because they're not going to believe. I mean, even the makeup and the hair, it's just like she just was like a butterfly that came out of her cocoon. I was like, Amy Joy, is that you? I had a look weird. Every time I see her, she's getting better and better. She loves the Lord, but she believes in being healthy physically, mentally, economically, come on, and spiritually. She's not about being poor and begging, right? She has a bachelor's degree in business management, a master's of science in organizational development, and a graduate certificate in conflict resolution and mediation. And she is also a licensed life and health insurance advisor. So she has a lot of things. I know she even deals with real estate too sometimes, but right now she's focusing on her new ministry. So would you help me welcome Amy Joy to the stage for Women in Business. And she's gonna tell you how she went from being an introvert to the CEO of her own company, and looking good and doing good. Let's give it up and encourage her, Amy Joy.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. If you could just go ahead and just stand up, just stand up, everybody, and just stretch, and then just say, I am here to break limitations. I'm here to break limitations. Say it like you're serious. Say, I am here to break limitations. Okay, you may take this. As you heard, my name is Joyce Mirandes. If you're wondering where my accent is from, I was born and raised in Kenya. And then, like many immigrants, my parents sent me to the United States to come and go to college. And so when I came to the United States, what my parents didn't know was I didn't know what I wanted to do. And so as an international student, you're not allowed to drop classes until you figure yourself out. So I actually started five majors before I finally discovered that I wanted to do business. So if you're confused about what you need to do in life, if you think you've wasted a lot of time, just look at me and know that God is able to do whatever he needs to do to get you to where you need to be. And so when I discovered what I wanted to do, I immediately graduated with my bachelor's. Then after that, I got my master's. But what I had was, I always had an internal struggle where I felt like I wasn't good enough. I always had an internal struggle where I felt like I didn't have what it takes. Even the degrees that I kept studying and stopping, the reason I did that was because deep inside, I felt like I wasn't capable of completing what I had started. And I know in this day and time, a lot of people are struggling with feeling like they're not enough. A lot of people are struggling with feeling like maybe they just don't have what it takes. Or you look at your life and you feel like you're too old. Maybe you can't change careers, or you can't change your path. But I'm here to let you know that this is your season for breaking limitations. 2020 looked like a year where we went through a lot of things. But 2020 was also a year of revealing. The things that have been hidden underground for a long period of time, those relationships that you kept having that didn't mean you any good, they came to the surface in 2020 because God wanted to reveal everything that was in your life. And so 2020 was a defining year. And even now in 2021, God is saying this is the season for Deborah to arise. And we know in the Bible that Deborah was a unique woman. Deborah was not like any other woman. Deborah was a wife. Deborah was a mother. Deborah was a judge. Deborah was a prophet. Deborah went out to war when she needed to go out to war. She wore many different hats because she broke limitations of her time. And in this season, in this time, it's not by accident that we are having this event on this day, but it is because God wants to break limitations in your lives. A few years ago, I came to my first event here, Women at the Feet of Jesus, and during that time frame, what Lady O didn't know was just a few weeks before I came for that event, I had gone through so many I just had a lot of emotional struggles. I had so many things going on. I just felt like my life was worthless. I didn't have anything to offer. There was so much pressure on my life, being told, you need to do this, you need to do this, why can't you do this, why are you not like so and so, and just a lot of comparison, a lot of tension going on in my life. And what Lady O doesn't know is that a few weeks before I came for that conference, I had actually planned to take my own life. I had my childhood, my son. I was going through just a very dark period of time, and I didn't have anybody to talk to because the enemy always tells us that don't talk to anybody. If you talk to anybody, they might spread around what you're going through. And so I decided to just keep it to myself. And the more I kept to myself, the more he would tell me lies about me. He would tell me that my life had no meaning. He would tell me that nobody needs me on earth. He would tell me that my life has no purpose. And so that night I put my kids to bed and I was like, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take this pill so that I could just die in my sleep. And what the enemy had set up for evil, God turned it around, because that night my son refused to go to sleep. Yes. I put him to bed. He used to love to sleep in his crib, but I put him to bed on that night. And when I put him to bed, he started crying and he wanted me to hold him. And I held him, and then when he fell asleep, I put him to bed again. And then and as soon as I put him to bed, he started crying again. And then I had to pick him back up. And we did that until almost 5 o'clock, and I was so frustrated with him. But I just held him and he slept through the night. And I tell you, that day, after some time, I went to my closet and I was just crying because I was so tired. Because when you have a lot of internal conflict, a time comes when you just feel tired. You just don't want to fight anymore. I was just tired. I didn't want to fight anymore. And I just had a voice telling me that I will help you. And I know that was the Holy Spirit, because after that I just started feeling some kind of peace and some kind of relief. And so when I came to the event, in that year, I think it was like 2017 or 2018. I can't remember which year, whether it was 18 or. But anyway, when I came to the event, they were talking about forgiveness, and I cried the whole time. Like, and I love to put makeup, I like to look good, but I was like, I just don't care, I'm just gonna be ugly for Jesus. And I can't even tell you what that event changed my life. And I know sometimes when you're setting up events, you just feel like, okay, this is a lot of work, maybe it doesn't make a difference and all that, but truly the event made a difference in my life. Because when I came for that event, God started dealing with me. He said, you need to walk in forgiveness. People have hurt you, and that's true. People have said so many things about you. People have done things to you, but you need to release them. And so the first thing I want to share with you, which is very practical, is just forgiving people. It doesn't matter what someone has done to you. Just know that God loves you so much. He already saw that those people will do those things that they've done to you, or they'll betray you, or they'll leave you, or they'll talk about you, whatever it is that they've done. God has already seen it. But He's a good Father. He is not wicked. He's a good Father, and He has a plan. The good thing with God is that He has the ability to take the good things and the bad things and mix them up together and make it all good. He has the ability to give you beauty for ashes. So as long as you're still breathing, that means that God still has work for you. As long as you're still breathing, that means that this is not the final, this is not the last hour. It means that God is able to turn your situation around. You might look at yourself and say that, oh, I'm already 60, what can I do? God can give you 30 more years, and you can live those 30 years enjoying yourself, traveling, discovering your purpose, doing the things that He has ordained for you to do. When I was praying, God was telling me that there are women here who feel like you have wasted so much time and you don't have time to do anything else. And God said that He is the accelerator of time. It doesn't matter what you have gone through. God is able to accelerate the things that could have taken you 10 years. God is able to do it in 1 year. And I can tell you that because we did that in my own life. When in 2019, I started my own consulting business called Breaking Limitations. And I knew that God had instructed me to leave corporate America and to start my business. And a lot of people told me that that's not a good idea. Based on your personality, you're not able to do that kind of work. You need to be aggressive. You need to be able to talk to clients. And that's not something that you're equipped to do based on your personality. But guess what? When I talked to God, He told me the only person who knows the things that are put in your life is only God who knows the purpose that He has put in you. Only God knows the potential that He has put in you. Do not allow anybody to limit you. And that is why even when I talk about breaking limitations, I'm talking about things that I've experienced because I've seen what God can do. In 2019, when I started my business, I have a benefit consulting, and also I help people with life insurance, health insurance, and all that. And people just told me, why would you even get into that industry? In HR, I was already managed, doing a lot of benefit administration and all that. And so when I was 4 months into my business, COVID happened. Everything shut down. And of course, it looked like, now what am I going to do? I had, this is the business I've been telling people I'm going to do. People have tried to advise me not to do it. And now everything has shut down. But guess what? God had another plan. Because in 2020, the people who never used to get insurance were looking for me.
Wow.
The companies that never used to offer insurance were looking for me.
Yes.
The businesses that never used to care about having health insurance were looking for me. And so I used to, because I couldn't go out and network because I was at home trying to homeschool my kids and do all the Zooms and everything, I just used to do my business. I would just do little sessions on Facebook explaining to people how benefits work, because there's a lot of confusion when it comes to health insurance. So just giving people advice on things that they really want to know about. And before I knew it, people started reaching out to me on Facebook, asking me, please, I need health insurance. Oh, could you explain this to me? Oh, my company needs this. And I just started getting people reaching out to me. And I was only licensed in Texas. And I wasn't even planning to be licensed anywhere else. I wasn't even thinking that far. But God had another plan. I started getting people calling me from South Carolina, from North Carolina, from Virginia, from Missouri, from Tennessee, from Alabama. And guess what? So I had to quickly get licensed in those different places so that I could be able to do what I could be able to manage so that I don't lose this business. And then someone reached out to me and they told me they want international insurance because they travel around the world and they want to make sure that with this COVID season they have to have good coverage. And of course I didn't know anything about international insurance. I was just starting off and I'm just trying to get certified in the United States. But I was able to connect with someone who I had met at an event. And that person told me that they've been doing insurance for 30 years and their focus was helping people with athletes with insurance. And so athletes, of course, they come from different countries and all that, so they can play basketball or whatever. And so they were able to help me to help this one person. This one person loved his insurance because when he went to different countries, he got sick. He called me and I was able to help him get everything situated. And before you know it, I had other executives of companies calling me, telling me from other countries now, calling me to tell me that I need you to help us get the same kind of insurance that you helped this other executive get. And so before you know it, I was getting so many calls. So I want you to know that it doesn't matter. I wasted like 8 years trying to do my bachelor's. The people who I had started with were already way into their careers. But we serve a God who is able to accelerate you. God is able to accelerate you. It doesn't matter how much time you have wasted, how much time you feel you have wasted. God has a plan for your life. And in the middle of all that, while I'm busy trying to get situated in my business, I got this contract, a 6-month contract to have a TV show on Breaking Limitations with Joyce Marendes. And it's based in Atlanta, but since there's all this COVID, I do the recording stay in Houston. And that show has also, at first when I got the contract, I was excited about it, and then fear came in and I was like, oh my gosh, what is this? I was like, I need to call these people, I need to stop wasting people's time. And I was just about to cancel the whole thing, and God said, the same God who was with you in the business is the same God who is going to be with you in the show. And just last week we recorded episode 13. I'm gonna have 2 seasons, so right now we're in episode 13. I've been able to interview people who normally I would never have access to. But everybody that I've been able to ask has agreed to have an interview, and it has also helped open doors. Next month, I'm going to be interviewing some ambassadors from different countries. There's an event coming up, and so I'll make sure you get a card so that you can get more information from my website. There's an event coming up for entrepreneurs and young people. And Soraya, I hope you'll be able to make it, because that's how the thought of venture capital is there, looking at young people who are starting off businesses, and so that would be a great place to be. But it's going to have a lot of ambassadors and also NBA players who support the young entrepreneurs. And guess who's going to be interviewing them? So I just want you to know that it doesn't matter what you're going through, God is still faithful. You have to know that you are the apple of God's eye. And I love everything that everybody has said, even from conflict resolution to the love doctor. God is concerned about everything that concerns you. God loves you. God wants the best for you. And so if there's anything you're going through, anything in your life that seems to be frustrating you, that is intimidating you, just go ahead and just believe. Just know that God wants to transform you. And one of the things that God really helped me with the transformation was the mindset. God told me that my mind has to be transformed. We are a spirit. We live in a body. But in order for the spirit to transmit information to our body, it has to pass through the soul, which is the mind, your will and your emotion. If your mind is at default, the message that God is giving you is going to be distorted. That's why God says you are the apple of his eye, but your mind tells you you gained 15 pounds during COVID. You are ugly. And then you take what your mind is saying and you believe it. So we have to be able to focus on our mind has to be transformed. And I'm completely out of time, but go ahead and go to my YouTube channel. I do have sessions where I have talked about mindset. I have talked about the mind and how you can transform your mind, because unless your mind is transformed, you will talk about the word of God, you will confess it, but you won't see the results. Because when it passes through your mind, when the spirit word passes through your mind, it's going to get distorted if your mind is faulty. So your mind is a powerful tool that God wants to use, but you have to be intentional when it comes to your mind. You cannot let every thought come into your mind. The Bible says that you're able to take captive of what comes to your mind. It's up to you. It's not up to God. It's not up to the angels. It's up to you to watch what you think. So I'm completely out of time, but I have the cards there. Visit my Facebook page, visit my website, and you'll be able to watch some of the shows that we've had, because we've had a lot of sessions on emotional healing and on mindset and on different things that God has been teaching us. Thank you so much, and break limitations.
I mean, one of the things that I love to do is equip women to be empowered. And you don't have that power to do just nothing but sleep and watch TV. You have the power to do, the power to become, the power to make change in your home and in your community. So with that, somebody out there today, know that God is telling you, you need to start that business. And you need to get your net. We've got lots of people here for you to network with and hook up with and get what you need. So at this time, we're going to do some door prizes. And they're putting the food out, and we're going to get ready to eat. Now, what I want you to do, we have a gift card for the person who hashtags, now run, tell that. And so I want you, so Mr. Walker is over there, right over there. And so please. Okay, he's got a running list and he's keeping. So I don't know who's in the lead right now, but it's a $50 gift card for you. And so, who is it? Deborah Frederick, you're in the lead by 1 point, though. 1 point, they say. Okay, she's got a moment. I'm telling you, but listen, the reason we have that is because somebody else needs to hear some of the things that were said today to encourage them. So you're not just getting equipped and empowered to encourage yourself. You're encouraging and equipping and empowering somebody else. So we have social media here that people are using for all kinds of crazy stuff that doesn't make sense. It's not about anything. But the things that we have heard today are things that are from godly women, and we need to be sharing that. So instead of saying sharing that, when we say hashtag that, now go run tell that. Okay? So if you found out something today, you want to say like an amen, share with somebody else and do that, and you'll have your $50 gift card. So just keep in the tab and we'll let you know.